Hello everyone, in this video we are just going to interface 4x3 matrix keypad with our Arduino Uno development board. Let's get started. So in the previous lecture we learned the different methodologies employed for interfacing this matrix keypad to a microcontroller. So the one of the method is column scanning technique and another method is row scanning technique. I hope you remember these two, and we discussed mostly on the column scanning technique, and we are just going to implement that technique for interfacing this 4x3 matrix keypad with our Arduino Uno development board in this video. Let's begin. So in column scanning technique, we just want to configure the columns as input and the rows as output. So coming to the Arduino IDE, I just want to define the columns and rows for the keypad. So here I'm just going to write const int of c1 is equal to, I'm just going to connect the c1 to the digital pin 11, and const int of c2 is equal to digital pin 12, and const int of c3 is equal to C3 to the digital pin 13. And coming to the rows, I'm just going to connect the R1 to the digital pin 10 and R2 to the digital pin 9 and R3 to the digital pin 8 and R4 to the digital pin 7. So that's all about the pin differences that we require. So now, as I said, we are just going to configure the columns as input with the pull up resistor and the rows as output. So we are just not going to use any external pull up resistors for the keypad. So we are just going to enable the internal pull ups available inside the Arduino microcontroller. So we will enable the pull ups for these pins, that is the C1, C2, C3, which we are configuring as inputs. So that can be done by using the same pin mode function. So we are just going to write inside the void setup, which is the one time executable statements of the program. So C1 is configured as input with pull up. So if you provide just input right over here, it will configure the pin as input, and if you give a input underscore pull up, this will configure the pin as input, and also it will turn on the internal pull up available for that particular pin. And similarly, I'm just going to enable the pull ups and configure the C2 and C3 also as inputs. That's it, the input configuration has been done. Next, coming to the output part, we are just going to configure all the rows as output as per the column scanning technique that we learnt in the previous lecture. Pin mode of R1 comma output. So I'm making the R1 as output, R2 as output, R3 as output and R4 as output. So finally, I'm just going to start the serial monitor with a 9600 baud rate for viewing the data of the keys that we press on the keypad. So I'm not going to use any LCD display for viewing the button that is pressed on the keypad. Instead, I'm just going to use the serial monitor available in this Arduino IDE for viewing the buttons that has been pressed on the keypad. Serial begin 9600. So I have successfully started the serial monitor, and I'm just going to write this keypad as a separate function over the top of this void setup. So coming over here, I'm just going to name it as void keypad. It don't receives any parameter, and as I said in the previous lecture, we are just going to implement the procedure that I discussed in the previous lecture, where I explained you about the working principle of this keypad in column scanning technique. So the first step is, initially we are just going to check for the row 1. So we will turn off the row 1 and we will turn on all the other rows. So let me do that first. So digital write of R1 high. So here you can see I have successfully implemented the first step, that is I have turned off the R1 and I have turned on all the other pins. And once done, we are just going to check for each of the columns to be low. If any of the column is low, that is if this C1 is low, we will decide that the key 1 has been pressed. And if the column 2 is low, we will come to the conclusion that the key 2 is pressed. And when the column 3 is low, we will come to the conclusion that the number 3 is pressed. So we will check for these three conditions. So we are just going to read the C1. Digital read of C1 is equal to low. We will print 1 on the serial monitor. As we know, if the 1 is pressed, then only the C1 will become low. So that is why we are printing the 1 when we get C1 to be low. And similarly, if we get C2 to be low, we will print 2. And after this, you just want to give a delay of 400 milliseconds. This is just a debouncing delay which you must give for each and every keys. And similarly, I am just checking it for column 3, and if it is slow, I will print the character 3 on the serial monitor. So we have successfully completed the programming part for row 1, and let's move on to the row 2. So now what we are going to do is we are just going to make the row 2 low and all the other rows high. So here you can see R1, R3, R4 are high and R2 is low. The procedure is same. You can see I'm just going to copy all these things and I'm pasting it right over here. I just want to make the row 2 to be low and I want to check for all the three columns. If the column 1 is low, that means the key 4 is pressed. And if the column 2 is low, that means the number 5 is pressed. And if the column 3 is low, that means the number 6 is pressed. So I'm just going to change the numbers right over here. Column 1 is 4, column 2 is 5, and column 3 is 6. And I'm copying it wholly and I'm going to write it for row 3. So now the next step is we will make the row 3 low and all the other rows high. So this is the condition for row 3, and you can see when I press on 7, I will get 0 in the column 1. And when I get the low signal in the column 2, that means number 8 is pressed. And when I get the column 3 to be low, that means the number 9 is pressed. So I will change the numbers accordingly. 7, 8 and 9. And finally, we are just going to write the programming statements for row 4. So the final condition is that we just want to make the row 4 low and all the other rows high. And here you can see when I press on the star, the column 1 is 0, and when I press on the 0, I get the column 2 0, and when I press on this hash, I will get the column 3 0. So star 0 hash is the format. Star 0 has. So that's all about the programming part. I just want to call this function inside the void loop, and that's it. And whenever I press any of the keys that is connected to the Arduino Uno development board, that key numbers will be printed on the serial monitor. This is the logic that we have written. Now I'm just connecting my Arduino Uno development board and I'm uploading the program to the Arduino Uno development board. Now build this circuit to see the output in the hardware. Since I am not having a keypad module separately, I am just going to use this 4x4 keypad available in this development board which is with me. You can see this is the R1, R2, R3 and R4 of the keypad, and this is the C1, C2, C3 and C4 of the keypad. And we are just going to use only C1, C2, C3 and we will be neglecting one of the columns in this keypad. And once done, just power up the Arduino by connecting the Arduino to the PC through USB cable, because we are just going to use the serial monitor in the Arduino IDE for viewing the numbers. And then open the serial monitor. Now you can see when I press on 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, star, 0, has. All the keys in the keypad has been printed on the serial monitor. Our keypad is working fine. And we have successfully interfaced 4x3 matrix keypad with our Arduino Uno development board. See you in the next lecture. Thanks for watching.